How you doing?
Watch it.
We were playing a Negro club in this redneck Bama town with a handful of those Southern Union assholes.
Thank you.
surprised to see you out here.
Decided to get some fresh air. That heroin the Dixie Mafia's been selling? It's run out of there by a man named Charlie Kincaid.
Meaning all the other dealers around here kick up to him.
Charlie stays away if he can help it, so you're gonna have to put the squeeze on him. I flagged a couple of his guys. You get them to talk, they'll tell you how to get to him. Now, from what I hear, Charlie's only in this for the money. He's not a true believer like those other Dixie Mafia assholes.
So maybe if I talk sweet to him, he'll decide to bail on Doucette and come work for me. Assuming I can draw him out.
I got something I can help you with that. That's what I wanted to show you. New Bordeaux's on a standard communication grid. So getting a system of wiretaps up and running should be fairly easy. Just install this little beauty on a junction box, and I'll be able to construct an intelligence map of the nearby area.
How many more of these you got?
Just those. The parts are on an agency watch list. But if you manage to dig up more of them, we could wiretap the entire city.
All right.
God damn it! People think living under these commie motherfuckers is so great they should move their asses over to Moscow. You find more of these, you bring them to me.
You are way too sensitive about that shit, man.
Oh, fuck those motherfuckers. Fucking traitors. I'll see you when it's time to move against Charlie. On the set.
What you gonna do, huh? Huh?
Best not be screwing with me.
The holler belongs to us!
What do you say about the fans?
Finger Charlie told Zeke to go fuck himself.
So they're just supposed to sweat to get in there packing the dope?
That's what Zeke said. Charlie said, better that than little clouds of heroin blowing in everybody's eyes because some folks can't take little heat.
I could have sworn I heard something.
He must have skedaddled.
What's Four Finger got going on at the church?
There's all kinds of dope over at the church. If you destroy it, the boss is gonna lose a lot of money.
Nighty-night, bitch.
I ain't here to welcome you, cocksucker.
Get while I'm still friendly.
Pardon me. Pardon me.
Lord, help us!
Sorry.
Attempting to reach a coastal village near Saigon before nightfall.
All units be advised. Suspect located. On scene units engaging. Responding unit, visual contact with suspect lost. All units be advised, suspect located. On-scene units engaging. All units, search is called off. Repeat, abandoned search. Return to patrol.
Casse-toi.
Stay out of my face.
Coming to you.
Hello there. They're dying in the floor.
How are you, sugar?
Well, look what the cat dragged in.
Mm-hmm. Good to see you again, sir.
Got to explain to me why the hell we sending our boys to Vietnam.
Didn't we learn from Korea?
Maybe.
How your day been?
Wish it wasn't so far to the drive in.
I love watching movies outside.
look at you.
Mm-hmm.
How you doing?
Sitting around here with the Jesus staring at us does make me a mite nervous.
Take my money, pick up stakes, get out of Dodge. Too much shit went down here.
Hello.
Too much bad hoodoo. Feels like this damn city is cursed.
Out of the way.
Hey!
You think you're so damn smart.
Huh?
Hey, hey.
Sound of trouble right there.
You're gonna tell me about the dope operation.
The boss has got enforcers dealing around the hall.
Don't leave town. Your ass is mine now. How you doing?
When you're young, you got a fire inside. And it's...
Whoa.
Sure.
This darky some bitch.
Huh?
Don't you touch
that
me.
Him over there?
You best get going, you junky piece of shit.
I didn't see none.
He's here!
We will find you, cocksucker. Believe that.
done told you that.
No more
she
after
ain't
this.
Dead. Please, Lord.
Just shut the hell up about Mama,
Cash,
all right?
Straight up.
Every
ain't
day
you
is
fucking
the same damn
stuff.
Thing with you. She dead and buried and ain't coming back.
Do not fucking move.
Huh?
What the heck?
Best not be screwing with me.
There. Huh?
Watch out!
I've been listening in on old Charlie, and he isn't such a bad fellow. He's more of a kinder, gentler redneck. And as luck would have it, his wife is expecting.
Man in that situation usually doesn't care who he works for, long as he's still above ground.
Poor Sap starts blubbering when the two of them talk about names. Right now, it's between Bosefus and Thomas Lee. Anyway, his guys have the church locked down, and all of them are more of the shoot first, let God sort them out variety of redneck. You get your hands on Charlie, though. He'll do what he's told without putting up much of a fuss. All your intel's been updated.
You going back to the motel?
After I get something to eat. I'll see you when you're done dealing with these inbred assholes.
What do you think George will do if he finds out all our dealers are getting hit?
He'll kill Richie for sure. Probably Charlie and Merle, too.
Fuck. Comes to that, my ass is vanishing. George will never find me out there in that swamp.
Charlie called in all the boys. We're good. Just need to hunker down and wait for that nigger to come to us.
Y'all settled on a name yet?
Was thinking about Thomas Lee after my old man.
Got a nice ring to it.
This shit with us getting hit doesn't get settled. My boy might wind up being named something else.
Nah, what? I won't come to that. The boys will take care of it, you see.
Jesus Christ! Ducking my ass wasting this waste of skin!
Motherfuckers better save some for me!
Time to blast this fucker dead.
Work for me, and you might live long enough to raise your family.
Okay, sure thing. Whatever you want.
That's good, Charlie. Real good. Send your men to the First Baptist Church. Those Dixie heathens have been handled.
I'll have some of my men come right over. And thanks.
State your name for the record.
Donovan. John.
Mr. Donovan, you understand that by appearing before this committee, you have explicitly waived your constitutional rights in regards to counsel and self-incrimination.
Sure.
And you further acknowledge that by appearing before this committee, you agree to disclose all information pertaining to the events that occurred in New Bordeaux during the summer and fall of 1968.
I wouldn't be sitting here if I didn't.
You were an operative in the Central Intelligence Agency from 1953 to 1969, is that correct?
That's right.
When did you arrive in Vietnam?
August of 1961.
Please describe for this committee the actions you took during your time in Vietnam.
I spent a couple months in Saigon. Then I was transferred to a base in Laos that was operated by the Special Activities Division. We trained and equipped the Hmong and then turned them loose on the NVA. We're running arms and supplies via the Ho Chi Minh Trail.
And you worked with Lincoln Clay in what eventually became the Phoenix Program.
Within a year or so, Lincoln was heading up his own PRU. We'd cross over into Vietnam and locate enemy targets and either kill them or bring them back for interrogation. Just thinking about it? Jesus Christ. You wouldn't believe the shit we did to those cocksuckers.
Fucked with the wrong brother!
God ain't forgetting what those motherfuckers did to this place, Mr. Clay. I won't either.
Everyone worships in their own way. Their relationship with God is their own business and no one else's.
How you doing?
This man's name is Jesse. We were just having ourselves a little conversation about Richie Doucet.
Listen, I ain't done nothing, you hear? I don't know anything. I was just taking a walk and walking down the street and she just grabbed me is all.
You a Dixie Mafia?
No. Yes. I mean, shit. I did it for the money, you hear? I ain't got nothing personal against y'all. I don't even carry a gun.
Where's Doucet?
He's out at the abandoned amusement park to the west of here.
Banned Saturdays? What the hell is he doing out there?
From what I heard, it's because you've been tearing things up. Georgie's on a goddamn warpath. He wants Richie dead. So Richie, he grabbed what was left of the heroin and took off. Said he was gonna lay low until he could settle things with Georgie.
How many men he got with him?
Hell, I don't know. All of them.
Hand me that knife.
No, no, please. No, I ain't done nothing to y'all. Please, I'm begging you. My mom, my mom, shit.
Go on, get.
He could want to sit.
He ain't no threat to nobody. Let him run back home to his mama.
If you wrong, there'll be hell to pay.